Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel Electrical Technology and Industrial Practice. So I hope you are all good. As you can see that today our topic is NGR, its application and sizing. NGR is also known as NER or neutral earthing resistor. In generally NGR stand for neutral grounding resistor. Okay, NGR stands for neutral grounding resistor, but it is also called NER or neutral earthing resistor. So let us see what are the specification, how it is designed and how it is sized, how the ohmic value is calculated and how it is connected. So let's start this video. NGR is connected to the neutral of transformer or alternator, for small alternator, not for the huge power plant generator. Remember this. Okay, so if this is secondary, I am drawing secondary of a transformer. This is secondary of a transformer. Okay, so this is the three output terminals. And here there is the primary, maybe in delta. Now this is called the neutral point. This neutral is connected to earth through a NGR or neutral grounding resistor. This is NGR. Now why this NGR is required? This NGR is required simply to limit the earth fault current. Okay, for transformer or for the your alternator, if there is earth fault on any phase, suppose this phase has got faulted, then the earth fault current will flow. Okay, from this point it will be through the earth, and then from the neutral earth neutral it will return to the source. It will be, the flow will be like this. Okay, so if there is an earth fault, the current will flow this way and here it will be returned back to the source. So like this the current will flow. But if the neutral is solidly earth, then what will happen? Then the entire phase voltage will be imposed and a huge current will flow. So for high voltage system, okay, the secondary having high voltage, like your 6.6 kV, 3.3 kV, 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV, 11 kV, transformer having the secondary voltage of this value are generally earth through a NGR to limit the earth fault current. And for 415 volt transformer secondary having 415 volt, suppose you have a transformer of 11 by 0.433 kV. This is delta star configuration, DYN11, say it is DYN11 transformer. So this transformer's neutral will be solidly earth, because 415 volt, if 415 volt imposed got any earth fault, then the earth fault current will be not very much higher. So 415 volt is solidly earth, but the transformer having secondary voltage of 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV, 11 kV or even 33 kV, this transformer secondary are through a NGR. Similarly, the alternator's terminals neutral point is also are through an NGR. So suppose you have a transformer of 132 by 11.5 kV. Okay, it is a star transformer, say YN0 transformer. Then this 11.3 kV, so this is the 132 kV side connection and this is the 11.5 kV side connection. Okay, so this will be connected through an NGR. Now above 33 kV, that means the voltage having 66 kV, 132 kV, 220 kV or 440 kV, there the neutral is solidly earth, because designing an NGR for such a high voltage level is very difficult, uneconomic and is a very bulky design. So for those voltage level, the neutrals are get solidly earth. Their earth fault currents are taken care by the grounding design, that I will not discuss in this video. that I will make separate video later on. But for this voltage level, 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV, 11 kV, 33 kV, the transformer neutrals are always are through NGR. I should not say always, there are exceptions, but it should be earth through an NGR. Okay, so now we will see that how the ohmic value of the resistance is calculated. So this resistance is placed to limit the earth fault current. There are also other methods to limit the earth fault current, like imposing, connecting the reactance or arc suppression coil, but NGR is the most common technique used in industry to limit the earth fault current. Now we will see how the sizing is done or how the ohmic value is calculated. So now see, suppose this is my transformer secondary. I am not drawing the primary, okay, I am only dealing with the secondary. This is my transformer secondary. Here there is a primary. Suppose this is 33 by 11.5 kV transformer. Okay, so NGR is connected at this point. Now I have to calculate the ohmic value of this. So for calculating the ohmic value of NGR, first what you have to do, you have to limit the earth fault current. You have to select the value of the earth fault current at which you want to limit. In general, for 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV, 11 kV, 33 kV, the earth fault current is restricted up to, restricted to 400 ampere. Okay. In general practice is that the earth fault current is restricted to 400 ampere. So how the NGR will be specified? Here the specification of NGR will be 400 ampere. Remember, NGR is expressed in ampere to its limiting value. Okay. And for which time the fault have to be limited, and obviously the ohmic value. So rating of the NGR will be 400 ampere, say for 10 seconds. That means the NGR should be capable of withstanding 400 ampere for 10 seconds. Now we have to calculate the ohmic value. Okay. So what will be the ohmic value? Suppose this is a 11.5 kV transformer. So when there is an earth fault, then only this phase voltage will be applied between this earth point and this. Okay, see, these two are same point. So only this phase voltage will be applicable. This V phase will be responsible for driving the current, right? Understand that carefully. Suppose this point has got broken and connected to earth. And this neutral is earth through an NGR. So only this phase voltage will be allowing the current flow through this circuit. So if we want to limit it at 400 ampere, what will be the value of the NGR? NGR resistance will be 11 into 1000, that is voltage, 11 voltage by root 3, because we have to consider the phase voltage. Okay, so 11 by root 3 into 400 ampere at which we want to restrict. So what will be this value? This will be your 11 into 1000 by 1.732 by 400. So your ohmic value will be 15.877, that is 15.88 ohm. So applying 15.88 ohm to a 11 kV transformer, actually I have made a small mistake here. This will be not 11, okay, this will be 11.5. actually the division will be through 11.5 into 1000. This is not correct. I'm very sorry, this is not correct. The NGR value will be 11.5 into 1000 by 1.732 into 400, because 11.5 kV is a line to line no load voltage. So 11.5 by root 3 is the line to phase no load voltage. Now 11 kV is the load voltage. Whenever there is load connected, then the voltage drop will make the terminal voltage as 11 kV. But when there is an earth fault, that means the phase has been disconnected from the load. Okay, so that is why we have to consider the no load voltage. So it will be 11.5 into 1000, 11.5 into 1000 by 1.732 by 400. So it is 16.599 or 16.6 ohm. So this will be the value of the NGR. So what will be for 6 point, suppose a transformer have a voltage ratio of 33 by 6.9 kV, then what will be the NGR value to restrict it at 400 ampere? How we will calculate? It will be 6.9 into 1000 by 1.732 into 400. Now remember, 6.9 is the no load voltage of 6.6 kV. okay, so it will be 6.9 into 1000 by 1.732 by 400. So it is 9.959 ohm, that is something around 10 ohm. So this NGR will be specified as, suppose I am specifying this NGR for 11 kV voltage. So for 11 kV, this NGR will be specified as 16.6 ohm, 400 ampere, 10 second, 11.5 kV NGR, right? And for 6.6 kV, what will be its specification? It will be 10 ohm, 400 ampere, 10 second, 6.9 kV NGR. So like this, that NGR will be specified. So I hope you have enjoyed the technique to calculate the ohmic value of the NGR and you have understood the application of NGR. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, share with your friend, comment and subscribe my channel. Also please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications. I will see you in my next video. Thank you very much for watching this video.